Experiment time again. Can we start up Windows 11 on 1 core and 1 gig of RAM? This is my Windows 11 DE environment that I'm using, and I'm using for videos. I gave it 1 core, 1 gig of RAM. Let's see if it's going to start up. And again, it's a Ryzen 5, 1 gig of RAM, 2400 megahertz. It is in a VM because you cannot install, you know, Windows 11 on this low CPU requirements and RAM requirements, and with, of course, TPM. And it's running off a VM that's running off a SSD. So I did this with the Q4 OS, the Trinity desktop, and it actually crashed. I managed to crash Linux. I think that's because it was using a 5.10 kernel that don't have a lot, apparently don't have a lot of the newer memory management stuff going into it. I will say this is like really slow. Oh, we got our good old little turtle here. Like I said, this is a system I use. So it's set up with desktop, in you know, development tools and stuff like that. And I also have a plugin that should round the corners of the taskbar in a bit. VirtualBox editions need to be upgraded. Like, is this something you could live with? Of course not. Of course not. But at least it has not crashed the system yet. Like, the turtle is looking at me with just mental eyes. Let's just open a file manager to begin with. What are we opening here? This is the file manager. And it's, yeah, the Trinity desktop did, of course, run way, way more smoother than this. Way more smoother than this. So let's open up Chrome. Heck, let's open up PyCharm. That's a heavy hitter. Also, let's open up Task Manager. It's going to take some time, peeps. This is like my grandmother trying to run a fucking 100-yard dash. Come on, baby. I should have opened the task manager first. Oh, that's coming. If we go in here. And yeah, it's really going mental here. And if you go in here, you can see there's no logical, like, there's, I can't even show more processors. It's just one core. And you can see my system up here. So if I'm, oh, this is like not going well. So what I'm looking for right now is that, so Ubuntu Cinnamon did not crash on me when I was doing stuff like this. Let's make this as slow as possible and put it up here in the corner. Boink. So Ubuntu Cinnamon didn't crash on me. Windows 10 didn't crash on me. Q4 OS with the Trinity desktop that I pursed in my comment section said that that would be running even better than any of those was the only one to crash. By having YouTube running, it was granted it was Firefox, but I had some social media running, and it basically crashed the whole desktop. And yes, this is massively slow, but at least it's not crashing the desktop. What is memory saying? This is probably the most interesting stuff, the memory. If you do like this here a little bit. Because the CPU is just maxing out. And it says it's running at 3.6 gigahertz. If I'm looking at my whole system, it's running more or less at 4 plus gigahertz. So I'm really giving it a lot of modern technologies and modern advances that you wouldn't otherwise not have on a 1 core, 1 gig system. You know, you will not have all of the built-in advantages and optimizations that you have on modern systems just by default. But I can already tell here, when I was running Q4 OS, I was having a little bit easier time. A little bit easier time, but not much. At least Firefox did start up. But I'm also, I think it's because I'm opening up PyCharm in the backend. I didn't do that on Trinity. So if you can see all of this shit. Yeah, PyCharm here is going mental in the back end here. And all I did under the, again, I will have a link to the video down in the description. All I did in the Q4 OS was I was opening, I had HTOP, Terminal, what else did I have? I had Firefox, and we installed OpenOffice. I opened OpenOffice, crapped the system out. And I will bet and say that PyCharm, being the unoptimized piece of shit that it is, I'm sorry for all you PyCharm lovers out there, PyCharm is way less optimized than OpenOffice, at least in my humble opinion. And I think if I kill PyCharm, we will probably get a way better experience. You see here how much memory it's taking and it's disk space. So I'm actually tasking Windows out here, Windows 11 out here, more than I was tasking out. Tasking out Linux Q4 OS in the beginning. Let's be honest, nobody would want to use this piece of shit in this state, you know, but I can still use it. Well, kind of, well, almost not use it, but it's still running. I can still interact with it. What happens if I kill PyCharm? End task. And this will probably also take forever to end that task. Oh, something happened over there. Did I kill PyCharm? I killed PyCharm. Chrome is still unresponsive. Oh, kind of not unresponsive. So that actually gave us a little bit more headroom. And I'm, let's be honest here, I'm running Windows 11 as it was not meant to be run. Like, I'm running it in a with a graphic card that has like 124 megabytes of RAM, basically. So did I with Linux, so did I with Windows 10, you know, when I say Linux, Q4 OS and Ubuntu, respectively. So again, like I said in the Linux video, so let's do YouTube. That was the one I was testing out where it was really, really bad. So what I'm saying here is, and like I said with the Q4 OS system is, or video is, that this is not a Windows issue. It's not a Linux issue. It's what we're talking about here is, Do you want your system to be crappy 100% or 95%? No matter what Linux distribution you're using, with whatever DE you're using, when you're doing real world stuff like we're doing right here, you will have issues. It's just that Linux, just, you know, you can probably do 5 or 10 or 20% more before you get into real issues, but you will still get into real issues really fast. Linux is not the issue. Windows is not the issue. It's the hardware. And I keep trying to say this to people, is that in the end, no matter what operating system we are running, it all comes down to our hardware. It's basically the hardware that determines our experience, with capability problems or lack of them, with support. You know, do the OS support it or not? Already here, the Q4 OS is doing way better than the Windows is, or Windows 11 in this case. But still, only like 5 or 10% better, maybe 20 at most. You get the idea here, and it's really struggling here, by the way. And I again, you may see long gaps with no speeds or something like that. I'm trying to edit as little as possible so you can get a real experience of what's going on. See you all later. Bye-bye.